just a boxer don't mean that something's wrong. I don't know about you guys, but I feel perfectly fine. About to head to the gym, spar. So all that, cancel the fight talk, stop all that. We train hard. We're just passionate about the things we feel. We need to be passionate about it. Come on now. Just because I'm not just a boxer don't mean that something's wrong. Smoking weed. But you'll make me stop smoking weed. Nah, don't open that. I don't know what that is. You never know who that is. Who is that? Oh, that's my pops? What's happening?
I'm trying to go to the studio.
You're trying to go to the studio? Let him know.
I want to go to the studio.
He wants to go to the studio. Hey, who we getting signed by?
Huh?
Universal Records doing a partnership deal with We Don't Miss Records.
That's what I heard. I want to see the contract, though.
Oh, we're getting it. Don't worry.
All right.
All right. Anyways, so we already worth $1 billion. You know, technically in my investments, I'm already worth $1 billion. So if you think I give a fuck, I don't. Because just wait till I get my money right. Da 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 da. Just wait till I get my money right. Imagine being 25 years old and worth $1 billion. I want to see what y'all would do. Probably more than some weed. Anyways, I'm going to sue the NYC Commission, and I'm saying this why. They're trying to challenge me for a mental evaluation. I said, okay, what is your premises for the mental evaluation? Well, your tweets and your posts, I said, is it not my U.S. constitutional right to have free speech? So because I'm tweeting what I'm tweeting, that's premises for a mental evaluation. That's curious. So now you're trying to mess with my constitutional rights. Now I'm going to sue you. I'm going to sue you for defamation of character, actually. I'm actually going to sue you now. And on top of it, like I was saying before, they won't test Mike Tyson if he fought in New York, but they will test me. Sounds a little fishy to me. And I love Mike. Mike loves me. But at the end of the day, I cannot wait for them to actually take me to court, because I will literally defeat them. I will literally defeat them in court because my own therapist told me I should be smoking weed. She told me, why aren't you allowed to smoke weed? Thank you. Thank you, Ari. Shout out, Ari. And then she goes, you know, maybe you should try ashwagandha. I never even tried ashwagandha. She said that it will help me. And then she said, why haven't you tried shrooms? I'm like, I wouldn't try shrooms. I don't ever try shrooms. Like, shrooms is not my thing, you know? I never even tried it once. But she's the one that mentioned that to me. So what I'm saying is, so if my therapist say weed will help me and they're stopping me from smoking weed, that should be against the law. If it's going to help me, right? Yes or no? Yes or no? I'm not lying. Why the fuck would I lie, you stupid AJ? AJ, yeah. No, dude, just because weed is natural, they're trying to take it away, bro. It's crazy.
But you're not smoking,
now. No, I'm not going to say I'm not, because then I would be a liar. Cannot say. I'm never a liar. That's the one thing I'm not. I tell people straight up, and then we figure it out. I do not lie. That's the one thing I don't do. Hey, you look just like me. That picture was crazy. Yeah, that was crazy.
I was like, just like the same. Literally.
That was crazy. Bro, George Janko, don't say don't smoke, bro. George, bro, you don't know anything, bro. You're just a baby, bro. You're a kid, bro. Nobody said not to smoke, bro. Get on this live, bro. You're crazy, bro. You don't know anything. You're just a kid right now, bro. You're a baby. You're just a little bit baby. I'll debate you right here on this live if you really want. I'm not. I just said he's a baby. Is that really insulting? He's a baby. That's literally the nicest word I could have said. Let the Lord's will be done, not mine. That's it. That's what I give all praise to Jesus. That's it. Yeah, let a homie throw one in the air, bro. You know what they say? They say don't hide it, light it. The fuck? Bro, pass the blunt. It's all good. Haters, bro. me. You can't do me dirty. I'm going to go live with George Janko. Shout out George Janko. You guys don't know anything, bro. You guys are kids, bro. Yo, what's up, George?
How are you?
I'm amazing. How are you doing? My VADA test says I'm clean. So if my VADA test says I'm clean, you shouldn't worry about me.
Well, no, I just worry about my friends when everybody's telling me to worry about it. But how are you doing? I've been trying to get a hold of you. I haven't been able to get a hold of you.
You know, a lot's been going on, bro. I've been doing a lot of moves. And just every day I'm relentless against these pedophile and fucking asshole bitch-ass motherfucking devil worshippers. And if nobody gets behind me, they're also devil worshippers. Low-key, indirectly, or directly, they're fucking devil worshippers. If you do not spread that 460,000 kids go missing a year and are sold to auction and are eaten and burnt in front of themselves and literally get sexually abused nonstop. This is real facts. Everybody thinks I'm tripping, but I'm not tripping. If you've seen the shit I've seen, you would never be the same. The fact that I'm still alive is a testimony to Jesus Christ. The fact that I'm still alive is a testimony to Jesus Christ. They literally do this and nobody cares. Everybody's like, can you be quiet for once? Why the fudge would I be quiet when they did this to little kids? And everybody's like, can you prove that you were in the woods? Why is everybody focused on that? Obviously, I am going to prove it and I'm taking it to Congress on what they did to me. And everybody thinks it's funny. It's not funny. You would never be the same if this shit happened to you.
No,
you would never be the same.
Absolutely not. And I completely understand your point of view. And I think that you need to understand when people are telling you this, they're not saying it from a place of hatred. They love you. They're worried about you.
So I get
it. I understand it can get overwhelming, but just let's take a step back for a second. Like, you want to go to Congress and you want
to... No, I am going to Congress. I don't want to go to Congress. Yeah. I am going to Congress, and I'm going to take these motherfuckers down because the same people that are fucking the politicians are some of the people. And I know everybody gets scared, but if you only fear God, why would I be scared to say the things I'm saying? If I really trust God, if I really love him, then I wouldn't be scared even of the CIA, FBI, whatever you want to call it. I only fear God.
Amen.
So if you're not God, I'm
absolutely
not worried.
Absolutely. And I'm very, very proud of you for standing on your business. If it everything that you're saying is to come into
Ellie Seckback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
I'm Ellie Seckback.
Ellie Seckback reporting.
But ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.
ESNewsReporting.com. I'm Ellie Seckback reporting.